Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the line by line explanation of the third and final part of the chapter We Are Not Afraid to Die from class 11 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. To protect the weakened starboard side, I decided to heave to. So he wanted to protect the ship at any cost because one side was already broken. So he decided to heave to. Heave to is nothing but park the ship for a while in the ocean itself. This is actually a defense strategy so that he could save his ship. With the undamaged port hull facing the oncoming waves, using an improvised sea anchor of heavy nylon rope and 22-liter plastic barrels of paraffin. So using the undamaged part of the ship and making an improvised sea anchor using a heavy nylon rope and 22-liter of plastic barrels of paraffin, he decided to stop the boat for a while. That evening, Mary and I sat together holding hands as the motion of the ship brought more and more water in through the broken planks. So both of them were holding their hands and sitting together because they knew that they were going to die or the end was near because more and more water was seeping in through the broken planks. We both felt the end was near. So both Gordon Cook and his wife thought that they were really going to die because more and more water was seeping in. But Wave Walker rode out of the storm, and by the morning of January 6, the wind was easing. So he says that Wave Walker had crossed over the storm, and by next day morning, the wind was little bit easing. That means there was no strong winds at all. It was slightly low. The speed of the wind had reduced. And I tried to get a reading on the sextant. So he wanted to use his sextant and get a reading. Sextant is nothing but an instrument on the ships used for measuring distances. Back in the chart room, I worked on the wind speeds, changes of course, drift and the current in an effort to calculate our position. So he went back to the chart room. Chart room is nothing but a room in a ship where he can consult a lot of charts regarding the position and direction, etc. So he wanted to calculate the speed and the change in direction and all, and he wanted to see or calculate his position or where they were currently located. The best I could determine was that we were somewhere in 150,000 kilometers of ocean looking for a 65-kilometer wide island. So after his calculations, he could understand that he was located somewhere in a wide ocean and looking for a small island that was just 65 kilometer wide. While I was thinking, Sue moving painfully joined me. So as he was sitting and thinking, his daughter Sue came towards him and she was in great pain. The left side of her head was now very swollen and her blackened eyes narrowed to slits. So when he noticed his daughter, he saw that the left side of her head was swollen and her eyes were also swollen and the openings were just like slits. She gave me a card which she had made, and what Sue did, she just handed over a card to her father, and this card was made by Sue herself. On the front, she had drawn caricatures of Mary and me with the words. So when she handed over the card, he saw that there were some caricatures of Mary and himself. Caricatures are nothing but silly looking drawings. And on that card, some words were written. And those words were, "Here are some funny people. Did they make you laugh? I laughed a lot as well." So these were the words written on the card. Inside was a message, "Oh, how I love you both. So this card is to say thank you and let's hope for the best." So inside the card also some words were written. She expressed her love to both her father and mother. She also wanted to thank them. And she says that she was hoping for the best. Somehow we had to make it. So the narrator says that somehow he had to escape from this terrible situation. I checked and rechecked my calculations. So he was only involved in calculating the distances and wanted to know whether he would reach the small island that he had in his mind. We had lost our main compass and I was using a spare which had not been corrected for magnetic variation. So what happened in the storm was he had lost his main compass. So he was using a spare one, but that had a minute error in it. But then he also wanted to use it and find out how best he could locate the position where they were. I made an allowance for this and another estimate of the influence of the westerly currents which flow through this part of the Indian Ocean. So he made some rough estimates and also included the influence that the westerly currents would have on his ship, and he wanted to find out at what time they would be able to locate the island in this part of the Indian Ocean. At 2 p.m., I went on deck and asked Larry to steer a course of 185 degrees. So at 2 p.m., the narrator went on to the deck and asked his fellow crewman Larry to steer the ship to about 185 degrees. If we were lucky, I told him with a conviction, I did not feel that he could expect to see the island about 5 p.m. So he said, though he had some strong belief, but still he was not sure about himself. He said that if we were lucky, we would be able to see the island at about 5 p.m. Then with a heavy heart, I went below, climbed on my bunk and amazingly dozed off. Then he said he went below. He left the steering with Larry and then he went below. He had a heavy heart because he did not have any hope of finding the island. So he climbed down onto his bunk, his bed, and then he says amazingly he dozed off. He began to sleep. When I woke at 6 p.m. and growing dark, I knew we must have missed the island. So he went to sleep at 2 p.m. and when he woke up, he saw that it was 6 p.m. and the weather outside, it was completely growing dark. I knew we have missed the island. So he thought that he could have missed the island and now they are not going to reach it. And with the sail we had left, we couldn't hope to beat back into the westerly winds. So he says that it would be very difficult to go back into the westerly wind. At that moment, a tousled head appeared by my bunk. So as he sat thinking, he says that a head appeared, a tousled head. A tousled head means an unkempt head that was not combed properly and all that. So a tousled head appeared by his bunk. "Can I have a hug?" Jonathan asked. So that head belonged to Jonathan, his son. Sue was right behind him. So his son came and asked him if he could have a hug from his father. And along with her, Sue was also standing just behind him. "Why am I getting a hug now?" I asked. "Because you are the best daddy in the whole world." So he did not understand why his son had come to him and wanted a hug. Because he thought that he had lost the island and now it was very difficult for him to go back. But then amazingly, his son replied to him that because he was the best daddy in the world, he wanted to hug his daddy. And the best captain, he also said that his father was the best captain. "Not today, John, I am afraid." So the narrator was surprised because he said it's not today that he is the best captain or best father, because he knew that he had lost the island. "Why, you must be," said Sue in a matter-of-fact voice. But then he heard his daughter Sue exclaim that, "No, you must be the best daddy in the world. You found the island." So she also exclaimed that he had found the island. "What?" I shouted. So he was also excited to hear that he had actually found the island, which he did not expect at all. "It's out there in front of us," they chorused. So they all together said loudly that it is out there in front of us. It means the island, as big as a battleship. So the island was as big as a battleship. I rushed on the deck and gazed with relief at the stark outline of Isle Amsterdam. So he went out excitedly and looked at the stark, strong outline of Isle Amsterdam, the French scientific base. It was only a bleak piece of volcanic rock. So it was only very desolate looking. It was very lonely and there was very little vegetation on that, so no plants at all, only a few here and there. So at the moment, the most beautiful island in the world. So it was the most beautiful island in the world at that moment, because it was a kind of escape for them from the terrible weather that they had been facing until now. We anchored offshore for the night. So during the night itself, they anchored their ship offshore. And the next morning, all 28 inhabitants of the island cheered as they helped us ashore. So next day morning, all the 28 people who lived on the island cheered them and helped them to get on to that island. With land under my feet again, my thoughts were full of Larry and Herbie. So the moment he set his feet on the island, he was only thinking about Larry and Herb, both his crewmen. Cheerful and optimistic under the direst stress. So he says that both of them were fully happy and they were always optimistic even during the worst situations they had faced together. And of Mary, who stayed at the wheel for all those crucial hours. And he also thought about his wife Mary, who was taking the captain's place and steering the wheel during all those difficult times. Most of all, I thought of a 7-year-old girl who did not want us to worry about a head injury. So he even thinks about his daughter Sue, who had a head injury and who did not come and disturb her parents during the time of rescue, which subsequently took 6 minor operations to remove a recurring blood. So he says that the head injury took at least 6 operations to remove a blood clot that was reappearing between her skin and skull. And he also thought about his 6-year-old boy Jonathan, who was not afraid to die and who exhibited great courage and positive optimism during their efforts to escape from the worst situation on their journey. I hope you liked today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share, and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.